This is Professor Kim, and here we're going to talk about ideal sources. So let's jump into it. We have this symbol. This is a voltage source. These are independent sources, so they have a value for the voltage in terms of the voltage source. And we also have a current source, which has a constant current defined by something else. In this case, for the voltage source, Vs would define the voltage that is over the terminals here. And then it would have a current coming out. We're just going to call that I for now. And we can represent how this operates on this chart. So this is an IV curve. And so the x-axis is the voltage that we're going to see over the electrical component. And then the y-axis is going to be the current that is coming out of it. And this helps us visualize how this component can operate. So because this voltage source always gives a voltage, the same voltage, then we can figure out its value. So let's say that its value is here. It gives a positive voltage. So this would be on the positive axis. In terms of current, it can give any current. So it can give any, starting from zero all the way up to positive. Pretend that's a straight line. And can it give a negative current? Yes, in fact it can. So here on the graph, see this is the negative I, so it can give a negative current. And that would mean that since this is defined as a positive, current could also be going into the source. So this quadrant with positive voltage and positive current, that would be generating power. All right, so quadrant one is generating power. If the current is negative, but the voltage is still positive, then it would be consuming power. Right? And you could also ask, well, what about a negative voltage? Can a voltage source have a negative voltage? Yes, so I just say Vs is equal to negative 5, say. Then it would look like, I'll draw a dotted line here. It would look like this. So this would be positive current come out with a negative polarity or negative. So again, if we look at this, actually negative voltage, so if this was flipped, and current were going out, it would actually be generating power. But if it's over here, it would have a negative voltage, but then a positive current out of it. So actually, it would be consuming power. So this is an example, two different examples of a positive and a negative voltage source. And this is the IV curve for that. So remember that even though it's called a voltage source, it may be sourcing or supplying power if it's in these two quadrants, or it may be consuming power if it's in operating in one of these two quadrants. We can do the exact same thing with a current source. In circuits, we almost always have a dual problem. So the voltage can then be switched to its dual equation, or dual symbol. And here it's a current source. So now we have a set current source. We're calling that Is. And then we also need to define the voltage over it. So this is now, we'll just call this the V. And so this current source will generate any current that we set. So positive, negative, it's going to be that value. And so we can represent that again over here on the IV curve. And so the voltage, we're going to put that here, the voltage is represented on the x. By convention, we put the voltage on the x-axis, usually. And then the current, this time it's the source current that's defined, that is going to be on this axis. So if we have, let's say we have a current value, a positive value for the current source, then let's draw an example of that. So we would have a constant current source. It would always create a positive current at any voltage, positive voltage here, and actually negative as well. So if this voltage became negative, it will still generate that current. So again, pretend this line is straight. This would be an example of a positive current source. This would be the IV curve for it. Again, since this is voltage and current, and our voltages are defined the same way, current is defined in the same direction, these would be the same power quadrant. So this quadrant would be positive voltage and then positive current, and that would be generating power or supplying power. But if we had a positive current out, but the voltage becomes flipped, then it's going to be in this quadrant, and that's going to be consuming power. Now let's say we have a negative current source. So actually the current is going to be going in the opposite direction. We just have a negative value, maybe -3. Then let's draw that down here. So it's going to be a line again. It's always going to create that current, and it's going to be able to do a voltage that is positive or negative. So it follows this line. And then again, we looked at the same voltage and current. We'll see that if it has a negative current going this way, but maintains a positive voltage, it would be consuming power. But if it were in this quadrant, so this would be a negative current, and the polarity would be flipped, so the positive potentially comes down here, it would actually be generating or supplying current. So just label these, power, I think I said current. So for independent sources, power sources, we have the voltage source, which always maintains its given voltage and can supply current in any direction. It can be a positive voltage, which would be, this would be the IV curve for it, or it could be a negative one, would be negative here. Technically it could be 0, 2, would be right in the middle. And the dual problem of that is a current source. So this maintains a set current. If it's a positive current, it would look like this on the IV curve. And if it were a negative one, it would look like this in the IV curve. For all of these, when you define voltage and current on these two axes and have these polarity and current direction, this upper quadrant would be generating power. These two side quadrants are consuming power. And this bottom left quadrant is generating power. Hopefully you can understand how these two power sources work.